Hello everyone, my name is Harold Campos. I'm a Principal Program Manager for Azure Integration Services, and today I will present another episode of our Mission Critical series, We Speak, where we emphasize on particular and commonly used patterns and technologies in enterprise mission critical environments with Azure Logic Apps. The topic of today's session is IBM DB2. So what is DB2? DB2 is a family of data management products born in 1993. Including database servers developed by IBM. It initially supported the relational model, but was extended to support object relational features and non-relational structures like JSON and XML. For some years, IDB2 as a full function DBMS was exclusively available on IBM mainframes. Later, IBM brought DB2 to other platforms such as OS2, Unix, Microsoft Windows, and then Linux, including Linux for IBM Z and AS400 systems. It is the most common relational database for mainframes and mid-ranges. Now, what is the story between Microsoft and IBM DB2? While this presentation will be focusing a lot on Azure Logic Apps and the connector for DB2, we have been integrating with DB2 systems for the last 30 years. Originally with a host integration server, which is still used by our strategic customers for mainframe and mid-ranges integration. And then we incorporated capabilities to SQL Server to enable a variety of data integration scenarios and replication. And then we added features to BizTalk Server to expand these integration scenarios to our middleware, on-premises middleware, right? And then most recently, we are also enabling the DB2 data integration capabilities of Microsoft Fabric. Okay, so the Logic Apps DB2 connector, or the DB2 built-in or in-app connector, enables connections between our cloud, the Azure cloud, our product, Azure Logic Apps, and IBM DB2 databases either on-premises or in the cloud. As you can see in this diagram, it doesn't really matter where DB2 is placed, we'll connect with it. It offers IT professionals and developers direct access to vital information stored in IBM DB2 database management systems. And what is key is something that I just mentioned a few minutes ago, that the DB2 connector preserves the core DB2 client features provided by host integration server to our mission critical customers for more than 20 years, right? 20, 30 years. So this product, the core library is having around for many years, and they support all of the capabilities that were required by our mission critical customers. Working with the DB2 connector, this connector provides only actions. So we don't have a trigger for it because there are a different number of triggers that you can use. You can start your logic app selecting a separate trigger, like for instance, the recurrence trigger or the HTTP trigger. So in that manner, you can kick off a workflow and then use the DB2 connector actions. The connector supports parameterized and name parameters queries. So what does this mean? For instance, in the first bullet, you see select a star from table name where col 1 equals question mark, right? So that is a parameterized query. And the next one, select a star from table name where col 1 equals at col 3. That is a name query, okay? So I'm providing a few other samples on how to use or the syntax of that you can use in the connector properties. Some actions will return a result set, while others will return the number of affected rows. So we have a lot of flexibility here. The following are the currently supported platforms. So while we state in the official documentation that we support IBM DB2 for ZOS 12 and lower, and then for i7.4 and lower, and same for LUW, we strive to support the latest IBM release version of the product. So if you have a different version or you're running IBM DB2 on ZOS, the version 13, then we are happy to support that version as well to work with you, or we'll just provide the support when you need it. Some of the prerequisites are listed in this link here that provides information about This is coming from the original host integration server product, but it was thoroughly documented. So then you can take a look. Let me go real quick through these properties, right? So then there is plenty of information about how to specify each one of these parameters. Then when you proceed to create a connection, something important to mention is that so you have to give it a name, right? A connection name, and then you have to enter all of the parameters that are required to create a connection successfully. But there is also a property called connection string. And this property can override the rest of the parameters. In other words, if you have a minimum connection string like this, so that you can just place it there, you can enter the connection name, and then the connector will disregard the other values, right? And it will just use your connection string. There's more information available at this location, right? And again, so this is the program, the SNAs, internationalization parameters reference that you can use if you have questions about the code base report or any other topic that is relevant to the format that you are trying to access from or in DB2. Now let's take a look to the IBM DB2 built-in or in-app connector. But before doing so, there is something that I wanted to show you, which is that in the host integration server product, we have an SDK, and this SDK has been available for many years, right? In that SDK, you will find that you have samples under the data integration folder that you can leverage to test some of the core host integration server capabilities for the DB2 client. But something that is worth mentioning is that if you wanted to set up your own DB2 database, and then because you want to run a test, because you want to test our connector, or because you just need to do work on the DB2 database, and you don't, and you're given the right permission, so then you can use these sample databases scripts that we have available that basically you run in this sequence. You first run the SQL Server Create Database Norwin .SQL, which is something that you run on a SQL server, on your SQL server. So you have to, you need a SQL server for this, right? And in this SQL server, what you're going to do is you're going to proceed to create a linked server. So then what it does, what these scripts do is they allow you to create a local SQL server database, and then you will be able to create a linked server. And after that linked server has been set up, so then it will insert and it will move the data to the DB2 database. So then actually that's the way how I set up my own environment as well. I do have a database and permissions on my mainframe to do this work. It's just that if you need to do so, then you can proceed in this manner. So let me go to the I forgot to show you something else, right? So there is also in host integration server, there is a tool that is called the data access tool, okay? With this data access tool, you have the ability to create connections, to define connections to the different types of databases like DB2, like host files. You can access host files as well, informing databases. Right. So once you select, for instance, DB2 here, so you write, let's say CIS 3, right? And then you write the catalog information, CAT, HCampus, and HCampus and something, right? So once you proceed to enter all of this information, so password, whatever, you know, once you have this information filled up, so then if you follow all of these wizards, and you hit connect, so then it will create a connection string for you. And this connection string will allow you to just reuse it, right, and use it in your connector in Logic Apps. So now let me show you our workflow that uses the connector, right? So this is my in my subscriptions, I'm coming to my workflow. But before getting into the workflow, let me go to the actual Logic App. So in the Logic App, you will see that you have the ability to not only to create workflows, right? So you have the ability to configure the networking. So if you need to access a mainframe that is on your data center, so then basically you have to enable VNet integration. To make sure that you have a you can access these on-premises resources, right? So I have a peer network with Azure Express Route that is allowing me to integrate with my mainframe. So with the right permissions and ports in place and VNet integration, so then I'm able to successfully connect to the to this on-premises environment. Now let me go to the workflow, and in the workflow, I'll pick up this workflow CIS1 test workflow that I have. And I'll go to the designer. So I created this fairly simple workflow that has, it doesn't have the recurrence, but what it has have as a trigger, it has an HTTP request trigger here, right? So then just for testing purposes, there are a number of, let me try adding an action here, right? So we'll look for a DB2 in action, right? And then you will see that this is the in-app, right? So this is the version, the standard version, the version that we use for enterprise scenarios, right? And then you will see that we have all of these actions: delete row, execute not query, execute query, DB2 tables, insert row, execute the store procedure, and update rows. So you can pick any of them. So, but the prerequisite for using either of them is for you to create, as I said, a connection, right? So then I have a definition of a connection here. So if I select, so I have my connection that is predefined to my mainframe with my credentials, with everything, right? So then if I hit here, add new, so then I will have to enter here my connection and then a server name, CIS3, whatever it is, right? Then port number 446, then database, MyDB, and so on, so right? Or else I can just copy the connection string that I extracted from the data access tool if you happen to have host integration server, right? Or else you DB2 admin can provide this connection string. So then if I wanted to, let me do this, right? So then let me run this workflow to see what we have so far. Okay, well, this is what I'll do. I'll go through each one of them. This action provides information about DB2 tables, a listing of the DB2 tables. This one provides a count of a shipper table. And this insert row, let me change it to this value. What it does is gonna insert one row in this shipper table. So I'm gonna save this, but before doing so, I'll make sure that we'll run this twice, because I wanna show you that this execute query will show a count now, and then after I insert will show an increased count, right? So let me do that now. So let me run this real quick from the overview in the workflow. So I hit run, and then what I do is I have enlisted this trigger, or check this trigger, and then see what that is running. I hit refresh here, as this is a fairly simple operation, fairly simple operation, so it doesn't take a while. So then I'll go to see what happened. Right, so then I have the DB2 tables, they are listed here, which are exactly the ones that I replicated from SQL using the linked server to DB2. My execute query is returning 7 records, right? And then insert row was successful, right? It was okay. And it's inserted this record here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the number of the ship ID. Let's remember that we have 7 columns here, right? 7 rows. So then I go, again, I go back to the designer, I'll make a change. Let me just make the change real quick here, right? And then change this value to something else. Like Peruvian shipping. PSP, right? PSP.com, right? I mean, there's... So then once I have made a change, I'll go back to overview, right? And in overview, I'll hit the workflow again, run. Then it has been checked, trigger has been checked. So then it's executing as we speak, right? Run history. Then I'll hit refresh, see if it finished. It did, right? And then I'll go to see if the count has increased of this execute query, right? And we'll see, yeah, that is correct. So we have 8 records now. The rows and the insert has inserted this information, right? So again, so this is a fairly simple demo just to show you how easy it is to just work with the DB2 connector. All of these, as I said, all of these underlying technologies, they are based in technologies that have been around for many years, right? So we expect that this will provide consistency and reputation as well that the product received before. So then I invite you to use the DB2 connector. Thank you for your time. And again, so if you want to connect with me, then you can follow me on Twitter at hcampusu or YouTube in my channel, or you can just go on look for me on LinkedIn. Okay. Thank you very much for your